Logical properties in CSS provide a smart way for web developers to create flexible and maintainable layouts that accommodate various languages and writing directions. In this video, we will explore a real-life example to understand the fundamental concept behind CSS logical properties. Before we begin, if you're new here, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and ring the notification bell to stay updated on our latest content. Let's dive in. In the past, CSS heavily relied on specifying physical dimensions and directions, such as positioning elements to the top, bottom, left, and right. Properties like margin top, margin bottom, padding left, and padding right are commonly used to set margins and paddings. These physical properties and values make sense only when working in a horizontal and top-to-bottom direction. However, when creating websites to cater to multiple languages, logical properties and values become incredibly useful. For instance, Arabic is read from right to left, while Chinese and Japanese can be written vertically from top to bottom. Let's say we have this list of users displayed on a team page. The CSS for this list typically employs conventional properties and values like margin right, padding top, border left, minimum width, and so on. If we attempt to change the default left to right direction to right to left using the CSS direction property, the layout may not appear as expected. This is because we didn't account for how different languages are read or written in various regions of the world. Similarly, changing the writing mode from horizontal to vertical presents the same issue. For a multilingual, multi-directional website, it's crucial to have styles that can seamlessly adapt to different orientations. CSS logical properties offer a more flexible and adaptable approach to styling web elements based on their logical orientation, rather than relying solely on their physical directionality. Let's begin by addressing the layout for the horizontal axis, also known as the inline axis. First, let's clarify some fundamental terms used for logical placements. The vertical axis is known as the block axis, while the horizontal axis is referred to as the inline axis. Therefore, in the context of CSS logical properties, padding top can be replaced with padding block start, and padding bottom will become padding block end. When dealing with the inline axis, padding left transforms into padding inline start, while padding right becomes padding inline end. By substituting all physically directional keywords with the logical approach, our layout will automatically adapt based on the orientation being used. This ensures a consistent and reliable display, regardless of the writing modes and directions. Returning to our example, to make it compatible with the right-to-left layout, we need to relocate the labels from the top right corner to the top left corner. The right CSS property in this case specifies the horizontal position of the element. Hence, the logical counterpart of this property would be insetInlineEnd. If we want to position it towards the left side of the inline axis, we can use insetInlineStart. Now, if we switch the direction back to left to right, the design will remain intact. This demonstrates the adaptability and resilience of using logical properties in CSS for accommodating different directions seamlessly. Next, we should rearrange the left side of the border based on the direction. Consequently, border left will be replaced with the border inline start CSS property. Additionally, when we switch the direction, the spacing between the image and the text block becomes untidy. To resolve this issue, we can substitute the margin right property with margin inline end. This will ensure consistent spacing between elements regardless of the direction. Notice how updating just a fraction of the properties has opened Pandora's box of possibilities for adaptable layouts. Now, we can effortlessly switch the direction on the horizontal axis to accommodate languages that read from right to left. This demonstrates the power and flexibility of utilizing logical properties in CSS for creating versatile and inclusive designs. Let's shift our focus to the block axis, which essentially governs the vertical flow of the layout. We can utilize the writing mode CSS property to navigate in the vertical direction. Here, vertical RL means vertical right to left. However, this single update has completely disrupted the layout. Let's explore how we can rectify this by employing logical properties for the block axis. Once again, let's begin with the labels. In this scenario, the top CSS property should be replaced with insetBlockStart. We use the block keyword because we are styling for the block axis. Similarly, the padding should be replaced by the padding block CSS rule. In this case, we don't need to specify start or end keywords because both sides require the same value. Therefore, padding block can be used as a shorthand property. Next, let's address the minimum width. In logical terms, width is defined as inline size. Therefore, minimum width will be replaced with minimum inline size. Now let's update the styles for the image. Since the width flows through the inline axis, it can be replaced by the inline size property. Likewise, the height runs along the block axis. Therefore, it should be block size. Moving forward, we can replace the max width in the user class with max inline size. Then the padding can be changed to padding block for the top and bottom paddings, and padding inline will serve for the left and right paddings. Finally, we can split the margins into margin block and margin inline for the vertical and inline orientations respectively. Look at how effortlessly we can transition between layouts. By using logical properties, we can create more robust and accessible layouts that can easily adapt to various writing modes, languages, and user preferences. Instead of needing to write separate styles for different writing modes or languages, logical properties enable us to write more concise and maintainable CSS code. This reduces the complexity of style sheets and makes it easier to update and maintain them over time. There are several other logical properties defined in CSS that we didn't cover in this tutorial, as exploring all of them would lengthen this tutorial. But now you understand the core idea behind logical properties and how to utilize them effectively to cater to different audiences. Feel free to experiment with the code by following the link provided in the description. Share your suggestions or feedback in the comments below, and don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thanks for watching.